Hi, my name is Mustafa Zuhair Mahmoud. I am a radiology and ultrasonography professor and consultant. This lecture series will cover ultrasound physics and instrumentation. In lecture number two, I will continue talking about the fundamentals of ultrasound physics. This lecture will cover six topics, which will be presented to you in the following order: sound frequency, period, wavelength, speed of sound, amplitude, and intensity. Let us begin by discussing the concept of sound frequency. In general, frequency refers to the number of occurrences of a specific event over a given time period. In the case of sound, frequency is defined as the number of acoustic variable cycles that occur in 1 second. Furthermore, we must not overlook an important fact about acoustic variables, such as, in fact, acoustic variables describe the events that occur in sound waves. Acoustic variables include pressure, density, temperature, and particle motion. This slide concludes with the following information. The abbreviation for frequency is lowercase f. The hertz is the SI unit of frequency, and 1 hertz equals 1 cycle per second. The attached table depicts the typical scanning frequency range in medical diagnostic ultrasound. The higher the transducer frequency, the less penetration and the better the resolution, and vice versa. Keep in mind that low frequencies for penetration and high frequencies for resolution. We can reinterpret the previously stated facts by stating that low frequency sound waves have greater tissue penetration but lower image resolution. Thus, in order for the sound wave during the examination to travel deep into the body, a low frequency probe must be used. But be aware that this results in a decrease in image resolution. The converse is of course true. It's now time to discuss the term period. The period of sound wave is the amount of time it takes to complete one cycle of oscillation. The period is inversely related to the frequency mathematically. It is calculated by dividing the frequency by 1. Period is measured in seconds or any subunit of second. The shorter the period, the higher the frequency, and vice versa. And the uppercase T stands for period. The current slide's example and its attached solution can now be viewed to further solidify the understanding of the period. A wave's wavelength describes how long the wave is. A wave's wavelength is the distance between any two consecutively identical points on the wave. Please see the attached illustrations. Furthermore, the wavelength unit is a meter, or a subunit of the meter. Finally, wavelength is denoted by the symbol lambda. Sound, like all waves, travels at a constant speed and has frequency and wavelength properties. The relationship between sound speed, frequency, and wavelength is the same as it's for all waves. The wavelength is equal to the sound speed divided by the frequency. Remember the following as you work through the equation on this slide. The wavelength is determined by two factors: the frequency of the transducer and the speed of sound in the medium. The current question, for example, asks you to calculate the wavelength of 2 MHz ultrasound beam in soft tissue. Assume the sound speed is 1540 meters per second. We use the mathematical relationship between the speed of sound, frequency, and wavelength to answer this question, because we know from the previous that wavelength equals the speed of sound divided by the frequency. As a result, by directly applying the law, we will arrive at a solution. The fourth point in this lecture is a talk dedicated to the speed of sound. The speed of sound is the rate at which a sound wave travels or propagates in a medium along a given line or direction. The density and compressibility of a medium influence the speed of sound. Density is defined as the mass of a medium per unit volume, and the ease with which a medium can be compressed is referred to as compressibility or elasticity. Here, I present you the speeds of sound propagation in soft tissues and other materials. The images attached to this slide clearly demonstrate how sound travels through various mediums. What is the sound amplitude? The amplitude of a sound wave is defined as its loudness, or the maximum displacement of vibrating particles in a medium. from their mean position when the sound is produced. The amplitude of a wave is the distance between the wave's crest or trough and its mean position. The wavelength and frequency of a wave are not affected by its amplitude. Finally, the greater the amplitude, the greater the energy carried by the wave. The final point of this lecture concerns the intensity of the sound beam. In general, we consider the intensity of a sound wave to be the time average value of the power, denoted by the uppercase P, divided by the area, denoted by the uppercase A. We define the intensity in waves as the power per unit area carried by a wave. The rate at which energy is transferred by the wave is referred to as its power. As a result, intensity can be expressed in watts per square centimeter. You may have noticed that when people discuss the loudness of a sound, they use decibels rather than watts per meter squared. While the SI unit of sound intensity in watts per meter squared, the sound intensity level in decibels is more relevant for how humans perceive sounds. The intensity of ultrasound typically ranges from 0.1 milliwatts per square centimeter to 100 watts per square centimeter. This slide depicts the direct relationship between the intensity of the sound wave and the power, the rate at which the sound wave transfers energy. This slide, on the other hand, depicts the inverse relationship between the intensity of the sound wave and the area. Based on the previous explanation of the values as amplitude and intensity, as well as the clarification of the concept of power in ultrasound physics, here is an illustration of the relationship between intensity and amplitude, which is identical to the relationship between power and amplitude. In physics, the relation between amplitude and intensity is that the intensity of the wave is directly proportional to the square of its amplitude. For example, doubling the amplitude results in a fourfold increase in intensity, as does power. And when the amplitude is quartered, the intensity is reduced 16 times. Please like and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to receive notification of new video updates. Okay, see you later. Thanks.